Previously on Alan Wake, something I only know as the Dark Presence held my wife captive and used her to record a horror story that came true.
I'll bring her back.
Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story.
Alan?
I saved Alice, then wrote a better ending for the story. But not without a price. I was trapped somewhere in the dark place, a strange zone somewhere beyond our world.
It's not a lake. It's an ocean.
After the completion of any difficult undertaking, there are mixed emotions. Accomplishment and relief. Sadness, depression. For a while, everything was about the work. Like an illness, it consumed you. Changed you. You locked yourself away from the world to do it, and now you need to recover. Learn to live without it. Find a way to crack open the door and let the light back in. I knew this place. It was familiar, but wrong somehow.
Welcome to the night.
Everything had a surreal, dreamlike quality.
I can't believe it.
I had a disturbing feeling of deja vu. I had no idea why I was here or where I had been before this moment. But something was waiting for me at the back of the diner.
I could really use a tune right now.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
Alan, listen to me. Go no deeper.
What?
Focus. You're losing yourself. I will try to help the best I can, but it's up to you. Find a better point of contact.
What do you mean?
I cannot hear you. Please, you're the one making all this happen. Concentrate. This is what's happening.
Nightmares. Too deep. Can't take the pressure. It's too much.
Suddenly, Wake found himself face to face with himself.
At the sight of myself, the dream suddenly became lucid. The dark place, that's where I was.
You will need weapons. It's not the light itself, but what it represents. You will need it. This is not a gun. It is a tool in a logical process of elimination. Be careful. I will try to find a better point of contact.
I didn't understand Zane's message, and knowing where I was didn't fix anything. Something had gone wrong after I had finished departure. What the hell was that?
The diner had become deserted. Then the door was smashed off its hinges and Wake had to fight for his life.
Wait for me!
The world had become twisted. These trees didn't belong here. I knew it was my writing, but the words were jumbled to dreamlike fragments. Reloading frantically, the rounds of slippery stone was thrown away from the tent. The bed looked inviting, but it was just the radio.
But I had to go on.
She was startled by the phone. The GPS system was working. I hadn't expected that. Hello?
I'm trying to reach you. Can you hear me? Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Listen, I can help you, but you're drifting deeper. I can't reach you. You must come to me. I can't maintain the connection. Use the words. Follow the signal.
It made no sense for the GPS system to work. I doubted any satellite was in range here. These were alien skies. But it was guiding me towards something. Towards Zane? Something had shifted again. The dark place was playing tricks on me. It wouldn't stay still.
The town itself turned against Wake. Cars flew toward him. It cracked bone and crushed muscle. It oozed hate. It wanted to bury him.
Everything I saw was familiar, and yet it wasn't.
Hello.
I cannot keep up. You're going too deep. I will try to guide you. Follow the signal.
I'm trying.
You must face yourself. Follow me.
Oh!
The GPS system was supposed to lead me to Zane, but the shifts were interfering with it. I had to keep trying. I wouldn't survive alone. Changes were becoming more violent. The street wasn't so much ripped apart as it was missing. Like some great hand had reached down and scooped it up. Everything felt erratic, unstable.
Thank you.
I'm trying to follow your goddamn signal.
The dark place is playing tricks on you. You're still going deep. I'm trying to guide you, but it's hard.
What is this?
I can help you if you just stop sinking.
What? This is bullshit.
It's happening again. Brace yourself.
I was running after Zane, and he was telling me I was going too deep. It was ridiculous, but I was more scared than amused. I felt like I was being hindered by an unseen force in ways I couldn't fight. All I could do was keep going.
See Barry.
Look, wake. Maybe that's him. That's the way to the chopper.
I remembered this. This happened before we found Barry.
The playground. Wake's pathetic memories of the Wonder Years and the contrary little ward pretending he didn't miss his father he never knew. He surged up and beat Wake down, clearing around in slides, eager to cane in his head.
Thank you.
inside. He couldn't see the ceiling. Something was moving in there. He was lost. He couldn't find the exit.
Asshole. Shifts were getting more severe. I wasn't sure if the place got bigger or I got smaller. The signal was going haywire. I would have to find my way out of here. Zane left me a page. He was trying to help me.
Yowza!
Barry?
Hey, bestseller! Looking good! Well, no shit. What gave me away? What, the see-through thing? I'm a figment of your imagination. Just like pretty much everything else is. You.
That's insane.
Yeah, you're right. Everything that happened before made perfect sense, but this is insane. Good catch, Al!
Okay, look, I gotta get going. The GPS...
The GPS, yeah, I know. Follow the signal. Got it. So, anywho, I'm here to help you out. The thing is, you need to get a grip, all right?
You nag the way the real Barry does. You know that?
Well, hey, you know, be fair. It's not my fault you think I'm annoying.
I don't think you're annoying.
Ah, baby. Relax, it's cool. Just try to stay on the ball here. You need to do what Zane tells you. He's been here for ages. He's like the expert. Anyway, if this is insane, and it's all from your mind? What's that say about you?
I think the signal's pointing towards that thing in the distance. Fine.
Yeah.
Enough.
That'd be the Biltmore sawmill.
I was actually happy to see you. How the hell do you know that?
Oh, come on. Don't shit a shitter, Al. Deep down, you're always happy to see me. Can't lie to yourself. Know what I'm saying? I don't know anything you don't.
I must be a sucker for punishment.
So why don't you ask yourself that? Huh? Maybe you saw a sign for it back in the real world. Or... Maybe it's the sawmill, because I said it's the sawmill, and now you can't get it out of your head. You?
Fantastic.
No, really? And I always thought you went out of your way to avoid trouble.
Thanks. Thanks for that.
Shadows and ghosts and moths slicing through his flesh.